Hello, this is Mike Wilmot with Microsoft. Today I want to look at a new technology called Power BI. Under the Power BI umbrella, you have Power Query and Power Map. And we'll be looking at World Health data. Specifically, if you look on the TED.com site, a presenter named Hans Rosling did this presentation several years ago, and I wanted to see if I could replicate that using these modern Microsoft tools. What I want to show you now is a data visualization from Hans Rosling. If you're familiar with TED.com, then you've probably seen this presentation, the best stats you've ever seen. It's an interesting visualization, and it really focuses on fertility rates around the world and how those fertility rates are changing over time as women get more educated and as industrialization happens. So it looks at the size of families, it looks at the size of countries. There's several factors it looks at, and I'll show you an example of what those are. So it looks at the fertility rate, how many children people are having, shows the life expectancy of people, and it shows the population size. So the question here is, as time goes by, and as industrialization happens, what happens to life expectancy and what happens to fertility rates? In a perfect environment, life expectancy would go up as fertility went down, meaning that we'd be having less children, but they'd be living longer. And those populations would be perhaps growing, perhaps shrinking, and that's kind of what we wanted to see. Now, if you go to this gapminder.com and go to the data section, that's where you can find data from Hans Rosling, the guy that did that. So if you come to this URL and go to data, then it's possible to come in here and say you want to look at, say, fertility rate, children per woman. So I'll just highlight this and put that into the site. If I came into here and I type this in, that is going to ultimately give me a link to a spreadsheet here. And if I copy the shortcut here, then I can paste that actually into Excel. So let's go into Excel, let's go into Power Query, and let's pull data from the web. Now I could put that URL that I just got here, or if you want to be really fancy, what we can do is I've gone through and made a tiny URL of fertility rate, of life expectancy, and of population. So we'll go ahead and cheat on that and just pull these in. So let's go ahead and replace this, Power Map 1. And what we've got here is the data that relates to this. So we're just gonna, what we're gonna look at is, what we first wanna do is understand what the data is. You can see that we've got data going back to the 1800s. So the first thing that we're gonna do is, we're gonna say that the first row is headers. So we can see that now we've got the year on here. I'm actually wanting to go 1962 until 2011. So what I'll do is I'll remove everything but that. So from 1961 back to 1800, I'll remove this data. And you do that by essentially highlighting and then hitting delete. So remove columns. Now what this is going to leave us with is data all about all these countries, and it's going to take us up into 2011. I'll delete 2012 because it may not have the latest and greatest data there. All right, so now what we can see is we've got this data that goes from 2011 back to 62. Now what we can do also is we can unpivot these columns. This is fairly easy to do, as you can see in this context. It's very difficult to do just for your average person on the street. So really powerful capability there. We also might want to change this into say something that's numeric. So let's go ahead and change it. It's already a number actually, but that's good. Same thing that with this, we want to make sure that's a number as well. Okay, so now we've got our country, we've got the year, and then we've got the value. Now, what we had said was for this measure, this is actually fertility rate. So let's go ahead and change this to, what we're gonna do is change the column name. So country, year, fertility. All right, so there we've got country year fertility. We'll call this fertility. Okay. So now we've pulled this data in. You can see that the data is down here. I'm going to get rid of this tab here. Call this fertility. All right, we're done with that. So now what we're going to do is we've got the fertility rates by company. What we're going to do is go grab life expectancy. So let's go into Power Query again. Go to this power map 2. Again, power map 2 is going to go map to life expectancy off the Hans Rosling site. What we're going to do is kind of the same exercise. We're going to grab the data, and we're going to say that we have headers in the first column. We're also going to grab everything 62 to 2011. So let's go do that. And then what we'll do is we'll take our data, we'll pivot it down. So that we've got country, we've got year, let's go rename this life expectancy. Okay. We'll rename this to life expectancy. We'll also make sure that our column here is number. We've got a text here. We'll change this to number as well. And then we're going to hit OK on this. So this is our life expectancy tab. Let's go ahead and rename this to life expectancy. Okay. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to pull in our population. So let's go ahead and grab this as our URL. This is, again, population over time. So let's minimize this. Go to Power Query. Pull this from our Hans Rosling site. Grab the data. We're going to say use the first row as header. We're going to grab everything 62 and later. And now what we'll do is we'll take all of our columns. And we'll unpivot those. So we've got country, got year, and population. Okay, let's go ahead and bring this in, and I failed to rename this to population, so let's do it here. And go ahead and rename this population. Okay, so now we've got fertility rates by country by year, we've got life expectancy by country by year, and we've got population by country by year. Now that we've got three tables pulled in from gapminder.org, we've got fertility, life expectancy, and population. What we need to do is figure out a way to get to leverage the country and year information to pull in a singular table that's got all of this in one place. So this is where we're going to go back to Power Query. We want to essentially merge these tables. So we'll take fertility and life expectancy. we're going to do is we're going to grab the essentially primary key, and this will allow us to combine their fertility and life expectancy numbers. We'll change the column from selecting all just to life expectancy, and essentially at this point we'll be done with this. We also want to make sure that our data type as we pull this data in is the correct data types, because what we're going to do is we're going to leverage all this information in our new table. So let's go ahead and make sure this is kind of more human readable. Life expectancy. There we go. So now we've got country, year, fertility, life expectancy. Country should also be the correct data type. So let's go ahead and make sure that that's correct data type. Yep, that's text. Okay, good. So now let's come in here. We've got fertility, life expectancy. What we're going to do now is grab population and also pull that data in as well. So let's go ahead, and once this data is loaded, what we're going to do is come in and grab the population. So now with our merge table, we've got a general field here, and we've got a numeric field, which is great because now we can match that with our next merge here. So let's go back into Power Query. Let's go ahead and do a merge. We're going to take our merge table plus our population table. We'll select the primary key again of country and year. So now that we've got the merge table and the population table essentially joined, we can hit the OK button here. What this is going to do then is give us the option to pull in population information. Again, since we already have country and year, we don't need that. So we'll just go ahead and grab population. And as you can see, now we've got the table that we desired. We've got country, year, fertility, life expectancy, and population. Let's go ahead and rename this to something without this new column header or prefix, and we'll hit done. What this is going to do then is going to give us a table with all the information that we need. So we've accomplished our goal now. We've gone to Hans Rosling's site, Gapminder. We grabbed information on fertility, life expectancy, and population here. We pulled that into Excel, and what we did is we took these three tables, we merged them on country and year for fertility and life expectancy in the first sheet. The second sheet here has exactly what we want: country, year, fertility, life expectancy, population. Again, this is for fairly unstructured data that's disparate data. So it's all pretty phenomenal that we've got this one table now that we can come in here and we can rename it to Hans Rosling. Now that we have the data shaped the way we wanted to, we just need to make sure that we have the correct data types. So let's look at country, year, fertility rate, life expectancy to make sure that we've got numbers where we expect numbers and text where we expect text. We do in fact have that, so let's go to the Insert menu and go to Power View to visualize this data. So right now it's giving us more of a grid type format. We can get rid of this, anything that relates to Power Query. So we've got this grid format here. Let's go ahead and expand this. And ultimately what I want to do is kind of start fresh. So I'm going to kind of remove everything on here and kind of walk through the steps that I would go through to create a visualization here. What we'll do now is we'll look at our merge two table. This has country in it. We also have year as well, but ultimately we don't want year to be a measure. We want it to be something that we're not summarizing. Also, we want to start looking at the type of chart that we're looking at, or visualization. We actually want to do a scatter plot. This is ultimately going to give us something that we can create a time series with and try to get some insights into our data. Let's look at life expectancy and population as well. And what we also want to do is put our year in a play axis. That's ultimately going to give us the ability to look at this data over as a time series. So you can see as we're making these changes, we're going to get more and more clarity. We also want to look at population sizes that aren't extreme. So as you can see now, we have kind of a timeline down here. We have number of children shown on the bottom. So some countries are very, very high in population, but low in life expectancy. Others are very high in life expectancy and very low in fertility rates. You also see over time that as we play on the play axis, some countries that are high challenge countries that maybe have had civil wars or dictators, things like that, that you'll see the population rates actually, or life expectancy actually drop over time. So what we're ultimately expecting to see, though, is that countries will start with high fertility rates and low life expectancies, and over time they'll all move to the upper left. So let's go ahead and see if we can prove this out. So what we're seeing now is we're seeing that over time, countries are, folks don't expect to live real long in some of these non-industrialized countries, but over time, as education kicks in, as women go back to work, as there's better medical programs, you'll see that the data moves up into the left, meaning that they're having less children and they're living longer. So again, this kind of proves some of the theories that we had thought before, and pretty fascinating. You can also do things like you can filter out some of the data, and if you wanted to look at specific countries, again, that's possible. By you can filter on country if you want, or you could filter by fertility, life expectancy, population. So lots of things you can do in this to kind of get the data that you want from the countries that you're interested in by filtering on population, by filtering on other factors as well. So hopefully this gives you some insights into how to shape data, how to visualize it with Microsoft Power BI, and good luck, and feel free to reach out to me if you have any questions. Thanks. This is Mike Wilmot at Microsoft.com. Appreciate your time.